This tune is called The Redheaded Girl, and well, you remember what I told you about witty things to say, and you know, like, I could tell you stories about Fordwich, the little village that I live in, and how there's so many redheaded children there, and I've seen more redheaded children there than any small place that I've ever lived in. It's quite incredible. Or I could tell you about my fascination my entire life with redheaded women. I mean, my ex-wife said it was an obsession. But I prefer to think that it was more of a genetic thing, actually. You know, something that goes way, 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 way back. And I heard a story once that said in the very beginnings of time, back when the wee people, the fairies, and the leprechauns used to walk more freely among us, that back in those days, sometimes those fairy folk would intermarry with humans, and their offspring would spend their lives with one foot in the mortal world and one foot in the nether world, and that the strain and the stress of living between two worlds at the same time would turn their hair red. And that's how you can tell to this very day someone who has a little bit of that fairy blood in them. And that makes them sort of magical people. So I like to think it's a genetic thing. It's, you have to honor those people. You have to, you know, kind of be aware of them, because you never know what they might do to you. Thank you.